I have divided that video in different chapters so you can choose what DNS settings you want to adjust. First chapter is about changing name servers. Second chapter is for adding an A record. Third chapter for CNAME. Fourth chapter for MX records. And the last chapter is for TXT records. Let's start with name servers. I will click here, Upright Account, Domain Management. And next to the domain that I want to adjust DNS settings, I will see Details section. I will click on that. And now I will change the authoritative name servers. I will click Edit. And these name servers are the standard ones for Porkban. But if you choose a hosting company like Hostinger, Bluehost, etc., you will need to adjust that name servers. They usually look like that. This is just an example. In my case, with this name service, I will put the domain for sale on dan.com. Just a note, you will find the specific name servers for your case from your hosting provider. They will clearly mention what you need to adjust. I will click Submit. And it will take up to 48 hours to see the changes. Let's go to the chapter 2. As I said earlier, we will look here details and I need to edit DNS records. I reverted back my name servers to the original one for Porkban, or else I will not be able to edit the records. I will see a message that they don't allow me to edit anything. So I reverted back to original ones and now I will edit the DNS records. First is the A record. If I leave it empty, and most of the times will be empty, I will map the main domain to a specific IP. It will look like that. TTL is time to live. We will not adjust that. I will click Add. Here I can delete also or edit again. It will take some time to be able to see the changes. Again, your hosting provider will clearly indicate if and what A record you will use. Let's go to the chapter 3. CNAME. CNAME doesn't point to specific IP and we usually use it for www. This is one example when you want to create a Shopify store. But again, your hosting provider like Hostinger, Bluehost will indicate if you will use a CNAME. Again, I click Add. Here I delete it completely. Here I did again. Let's go to chapter 4. MX records in case you use some email like Google Workspace. Again, edit MX record. Usually it is empty. And for example, if you are using Google Workspace, you will add something like that, usually more than one MX record. I click Add and you can see. As I said, your hosting provider or your email provider will clearly indicate what MX records you will use. My presentation is just an example. So as I said, this is for the details for email provider. Let's go to chapter 5. The last one is a TXT record when you can verify that you are the domain owner. For example, if I want to sell one domain, on send on Zetto.com and I want to verify my domain, that I really own the domain, or if I submit a site on Google Search Console, then Google can identify that I'm the rightful owner. I will click Add, and again, as you see, I can see all my records here and how they look like. That's all from me. Bye.